Welcome. Today we would be discussing some problems on circular tracks. Let's start. So this is how this particular class fits into our scheme. So we have been discussing races, and today we would discuss some problems involving circular tracks. Before we start, let's review an important concept. You might already know this, but it's very important, so we'll review it. The concept of relative velocity. So the relative velocity is the average rate with which the distance between two moving objects changes. Right? That's the relative velocity, very simple. So let's say that this particular object, a racer, for example, on a racetrack, moves at the rate of 1 meter per second. The second one moves at the rate of 2 meter per second. In 1 second, he would have come up to here 2 meters. This particular racer would have moved by then by 1 meter. Therefore, the distance between these two, right, these two racers after 1 second would be how much? 2 minus 1, which is equal to 1 meter. So, what is the average rate with which the distance between these two is increasing? It is 1 meter per second. So, that is the concept. If the two objects are moving in same direction, the rate with which the distance between these two changes is the difference between their individual rates. Very simple. So let's see. If you notice closely, this distance is gradually increasing. And this is known as relative velocity. This is known as their relative velocity, their velocity with respect to each other. Now, the second case is when these two objects are moving towards each other, these two racers are running towards each other. What would happen then? Let's say that this particular racer is moving at the rate of 1 meter per second in this direction. This particular one is moving at the rate of 2 meter per second in this direction. So, in 1 second, what would have happened? He would have come up to here 2 meters. He would have come up to here 1 meter. So, what is the rate at which the distance between these two changes? 1 plus 2, 3 meters. Or what is the relative velocity? It is the addition of their individual rates. 1 plus 2, 3. It is the addition of their individual rates. It is 3 meters per second. So, let's see. So, notice how the distance between these two is changing. It's faster than both of their individual velocities. Moving on, we can apply the same concept in case of circular motion, and that is what we would see now, how to apply the same concept in case of circular motion. So there are two things to notice here. These two racers will start, okay, and obviously the distance between these two would grow, and when would they meet again? Right, that is another important concept in case of circular tracks. When would they meet again? They would meet when the distance between these two has grown back to the circumference of the circle, right? The distance between these two increases to the circumference of the circle, they would meet again. Right? Throughout our discussion, we would take the circumference of the entire circle to be L. That is our convention. Okay? So, when the distance between these two increases to L, these two racers would meet again on the circular track. So, let's see. So, distance is growing. It increases to L and bam, they meet again. It increases to L, right, this center, and they meet again. Right? So, this is the concept. Again, relative velocity is same thing. They are moving in the same direction. So, the rate with which this distance is increasing is the difference between their individual velocities. So, that concept carries forward, but the additional concept is when they cover the complete distance relative to each other, they cover the distance of entire circumference of the circle, that is L, they meet again. Again, let's see what happens in opposite direction. So, distance is increasing, bam, it increases to L and they meet. Of course, this time the relative velocity is A plus B since they are traveling in opposite direction. Very simple. So, Now, based on these concepts, right, the concept that we have learned so far, there are a number of problems which are formed in the examination. So, what is typically asked? When do they first meet? When do they first meet at the starting point, right? This is meeting on anywhere on the circle. When do they first meet on the starting point? And number of times they meet. Number of times they would meet. And these are some variations to the problem. Out of this, problems involving head start on circular tracks, we would discuss in the next class. So, let's start with some sample problems and see how to solve such questions. Again, we'll go by first principles, not getting distracted by shortcut tricks, which rarely help because invigilators are smart enough. So, we'll go by first person. So, there are two people, A and B, which are running on circular path at the speed of 6 and 2 kilometers respectively. Length of the path is 24. So, this entire thing is 24. After what time will they meet again? We are asked both the things, and when they'll meet at the starting point again. So, when will they first meet anywhere on the track, and when will they meet at the starting point if they are traveling in the same direction? So, again, what's the relative velocity? It's 6 minus 2, which is equal to 4. We know that they are traveling in the same direction. So, relative velocity is the subtraction. And then, what is the length of the track? It's 24 kilometer. So, how much time would it take for them to cover a distance of 24 kilometer relative to each other? Right? This should be 6. This should be added. Okay? And this is 2. Right? So, what is the time? It is 24 divided by 4, which is equal to 6 hours. So, after 6 hours, they would meet again. Now, let's see what happens after 6 hours when they are meeting again. So, after 6 hours, when they meet, the first one would have traveled 36 kilometers. The second one would have traveled 12 kilometers. This entire path is 24 kilometers. So, we can see that they would meet again here on this point. This is the first meet. Very simple. The key here is that in this case, in the case of when they would first meet, we have taken the relative velocity. Now, in the second case, when they will meet at the starting point, we will not take relative velocity. The relative velocity does not happen in this case. And let's see how to find this one out. When they would meet at the starting point? So, when would this racer which travels at 6 km per hour reach the starting point? He would reach here 24 divided by 6 every 4 hours. The second racer would reach the starting point every 12 hours. When would they meet at the starting point? When they happen to be together. When they happen to reach the starting point together, then they would meet. Which means that the time would be a multiple of both 4 and 12. And we know how to find that. That is simply LCM of 4 and 12. N, which is equal to 12 hours. So, they will meet at the starting point again after 12 hours. And here is a little animation to illustrate that point. Let's see. If you notice, the racers would first meet here, right, after a certain amount of time, and double amount of time they would meet here. Right? That's the point. So, now let's see what happens if they are traveling in opposite direction. What's the relative velocity in opposite direction? Is 6 plus 2, which is equal to 8. So, again, they'll meet at the starting point after the same time. The relative velocity does not factor there. So, that doesn't change, right? If even in the opposite direction case, that doesn't change. What changes is the time when they meet again. So, let's calculate that. 6 plus 2 is 8. So, entire 24 kilometers they would cover now in 3 hours. So, after 3 hours, if they are traveling in opposite direction, they would meet. And again, let's see what happens to what are the distances they have covered. Is 6 kilometers and 18 kilometers. And let's see how it looks in the animation. Right? So, they would meet somewhere right here. So, this is 6 kilometers and that one is 18 kilometers. So, this is the summary so far. So far what we have done, this is all that we have understood so far. Time for meeting anywhere, we have to use relative velocity. we can calculate the relative velocity, we know how to do that, and then LCM of the relative time taken to, right? So if there are more than two racers, if there were two racers, we compute the relative velocity, and then we can compute the time at which they meet next, right? So that is something we can do for two racers. If there are more than two racers, then the LCM of their individual pairwise meeting time would give us the time when they will all meet together at a starting point, at any point on the circle. And we'll solve an example of this in the very next slide. We'll do that. When would they meet at the starting point? Starting point, we calculate the time when each one reaches the starting point, and then we take LCM of that time. Very simple, right? This one is actually very simple. This one, we'll take another example. So let's see what happens now with three racers. Now again, three racers are running at the rate of 6 kilometers, 4 kilometers and 8 kilometers. And we are asked, when would they meet at the starting point? They would meet at the starting point. They'll each reach the starting point after these many hours. And LCM, if you compute the LCM of these three, we'll get the time when they all reach the starting point together. Right? So this one reaches every 4 hours, this one reaches the starting point every 3 hours, this one reaches the starting point every 6 hours, and this one reaches the starting point every 3 hours. So they happen to be all together, means that time should be a multiple of all these three, which means it is 12. Its LCM of all these three is 12. Now, when would they meet again, right? So this is slightly tricky. So let's see, when would they all meet? They would meet when they pairwise they are meeting. So if A and B meet, B and C meet, C and A meet, then they of course meet all at the same time. So when would they meet pairwise? So what's the relative velocity of A and B? It is 2. What's the relative velocity of B and C? It is 4. And again, A and C relative velocity is 2. So they would meet, right? The A and C would meet 24 by 2, which is equal to after every 12 hours. Let me write here. Right. Similarly, A and B would meet after every 12 hours. Then B and C would meet after every 24 by 4, after every 6 hours. And again, A and C would meet after every 12 hours. What does that mean? It means that if I take LCM of these three, they would all meet at that time. So LCM of these three is 12 hours. So after 12 hours, they'll all be together and they'll all be meeting at the same place, right? That's important. This is another example. So this time we are given, instead of speeds, we are given the time. So I've deliberately chosen this example to illustrate a point. The point being that when we are computing relative velocity, we can only add and subtract the speeds. We can add and subtract the speeds, not the times, and that is the key. So in this problem, we have to compute the relative velocity because we are being asked when would they meet, right? When, like, how many times would they meet when B has completed 10 rounds? So we have to compute the relative velocity both when they are traveling in same direction and when they are traveling in opposite direction. But we cannot add the time simply. We have to compute the speed first. So let's assume that the length of the track is L. That's our convention. So L by 6 and L by 15 is their velocity, right? is their speed. So what happens if they are traveling in same direction? It is L by 6 minus L by 15, which is the, right? So let's compute the LCM. 30 and 15 minus 6 is 9. Let me take this 15, 6 and 90, and 15, 6, 90, which is equal to L by 10. So the relative velocity when they are traveling in same direction is L by 10. So what's their time? Time is equal to, so after how many hours would they meet? That is, time is equal to distance upon speed, which is equal to 10 hours. Oh, sorry, it's minutes. So 10 minutes. So after every 10 minutes, they would meet, right? When they are traveling in the same direction. How many minutes does it take for B2 to complete 10 rounds? His speed is, he completes one round in 15 minutes. So 10 rounds he will complete in 150 minutes. After every 10 minutes, they meet. Therefore, in 150 minutes, they would meet 15 times. Very simple. Now, let's see what happens when they are traveling in opposite direction. We know the relative velocities would get added in this, that case. So it will become L by 6 plus L by 15, which is equal to 7L by 30. Now again, this is the speed. So what's the time? After how much time would they meet? They will meet after L divided by 7L by 30 minutes, which is equal to 30 by 7. So every 30 by 7 minutes, they meet when they are traveling in opposite direction. So in 150 minutes, they would meet 150 divided by 30 by 7, which is equal to 35. Right? So in 150 minutes, they meet 35 times, and that's the answer. So same direction, the answer is 15. Opposite direction, the answer is 35. Obviously, opposite direction, the number is bigger. Now in this case, we are being asked the number of racers, right? So don't get confused by number of racers here. We are only concerned about the fastest and the slowest racer. So just focus on that. The slower racer travels at the speed of A, let's say. Then the faster racer would travel at the speed of 2A. What's the relative velocity? A. The track is 1000 meter. Don't get confused by this. The circumference is 1000 meter. The track is 1000 meters long. Therefore, 1000 by A, this is their relative velocity. 1000 by A is equal to 5, or A is equal to 200, right? That's the speed, 200 meters per minute. So this is their A. What is the speed of the faster racer? It's 2A, so that is 400 meters per minute. Therefore, this 4000 meter race, he would cover in how many minutes? 10 minutes. So the trick here is to focus just on the slower and the faster racers. Ignore the other participants. Moving on. Now, some problems ask you about the number of meeting points on a track. So on a circular track, the two racers are runners are running, they are running with different speeds, so obviously they'll meet certain number of times. And such kind of problems ask you to find out number of times they would meet or positions of those points, those kind of questions. So for that, let's just sort of develop an intuition on how to solve such problems. Let's say that the length of the track is L, the relative speeds of two participants is A and B, and let's say for now that they are traveling in the same direction. For now, let's just assume all of those things. What's the relative speed? A minus B, right? Let's also assume that A is greater than B. So their relative speed is A minus B. So when would they meet? L divided by A minus B. This is the time when they would meet. What is the distance that the slower racer would have covered in this much time? It is, this is the distance that the slower racer B would have covered, LB by A minus B. If you look at this distance, right, we know that it's a function, it's a fraction, right? It's a fraction in B divided by A minus B. So if there are some common factors in A and B, we can probably cancel them out. Let's say that they are all even numbers, then we can remove 2 as a factor. And then we can reduce this particular fraction to smaller terms. So we can make it. So this is the reduced number, or this is also the smallest ratio, the simplified ratio of speeds of A and B. So it's the ratio of speeds now. AR is to BR. Notice that this fraction depends on the ratio of speeds, and that's the key here. This depends upon the ratio of speeds. And what does this fraction tell us? It tells us that at this distance they are meeting again, and when they meet again, it means that this condition is similar, exactly similar, right? If I rotate this particular track in this direction, this condition is exactly same as the condition which had happened at the starting point. So when would they meet next? They would meet next at a distance of 2LBR divided by AR minus BR. So this is LBR, AR minus BR. And similarly, again, when would they meet next? They would again meet 3LBR, AR minus BR, and so on and so forth until we reach the final fraction, AR minus BR into this number basically. We'll call it R. That's it, right? That's it. So what does it tell us? It tells us that when the two runners are running on a circular track, the entire track can be divided into fractions which are equidistant from each other, and the racers would meet at these fractions. Not only are their meeting points symmetrical in distance, right? They are not only equidistant, they are also equally spaced in time. They are 100% symmetrical in distance as well as in time. So keep this in mind, and this would help us to solve the problem, right? You can forget probably all of this maths, but just keep this intuition with you, that the points at which the racers are meeting are symmetrical in distance and they are symmetrical in time. That's it. Let's see some examples. So here again, there are two racers, and I have chosen different ratios for when they are meeting on the track. So here the ratio is 1:2, their speed. So they would meet only once. 2 minus 1 is equal to 1. They would only meet once. Right there, right? And they would only meet once, and of course, since they are meeting only once, that point would be the starting point. Now, this time the ratio is 3:5. So they will be meeting twice. Once they would meet here, and the second time after the same interval of time, they would meet here. Again, the entire track is divided into these many fractions, BR, AR minus BR fractions, and those fractions are 100% symmetrical in time and distance. Now this time the ratio is 9:2. So the ratio is 2:9, so they'll meet 7 times. So you can see, you can calculate, you can view this animation, and they'll be meeting 7 times. So they met here, and then they met here. Right, and so on and so forth. So you can see this animation, and they would be meeting 7 times. Again, those 7 points would be equidistant from each other. Moving on, we'll solve some problems using this trick. This our knowledge that the meeting points are symmetrical in time and distance. We'll use this knowledge now. So ratio of speeds is 4:3. How many times and where would the winner pass the other? So we are not asked the exact time when it would pass. We are only asked how many times it would pass. They would pass by the time one of them wins the race, probably this guy. How many times would they pass by then, and where would they pass? So let's see how to solve this problem. First thing is that we can assume, since we are not asked absolute times, we know that the meeting points, they only depend upon the ratio. So as long as we keep the ratio 4:3, our answer should be correct. So we take the minimum possible speed to simplify the problem, which satisfy this requirement of 4:3. So we take the speeds to be 4 and 3 and solve the problem. Right? So again, we are using the knowledge that the meeting points depend only on ratio. So it's a 3 km race, but the length of the track is 300 meters. So we are only concerned about this 300 meter. So what would be the time at which they would meet? 300 divided by relative velocity is 1, so 300. Right? And let's say that some units of time, let's call that seconds. Right? After some units of time, they would meet. So 300 seconds they would meet. By then, this person would have covered how much distance? 1200 meters. And this person would have covered how much distance? 900 meters. Where do they meet? This is multiple of 300. So of course, they would meet at the starting point. We already knew this because we know that they would meet at only one point. 4 minus 3 is actually 1. So they would meet only at one point, which is the starting point, and that is, that fact is verified. So where would the winner pass the other? The winner would pass the other at the starting point. Now we know that. And how many times? So they would meet first when this guy has covered 1200 meters. They would meet next when this person has covered 2400 meters, right? And this person would have covered by then, again it's symmetrical, so 1800 meters. Then they would meet again, and third time they would not be able to meet because by then this person would have won the race. So how many times would they meet? They would meet 2 times. Very simple. So now moving on, let's move on to the next question, which is slightly tricky. So now x, y and z move along a circular path which is 12 kilometers long. So the circular path is 12 kilometers and they travel, x and y travel in this direction. They travel in one direction, but for some reason z is actually traveling in the opposite direction. Z travels in this direction. Z moves in the opposite direction. Right? And x, y, they travel in the at the rate of 6 and 8, and z travels at the rate of 9. So the question is asking how many times x and z meet anywhere on the path by the time x and y meet for the first time. So x and y meet for the first time at what time? T x, y is equal to 12 divided by the relative velocity of x and y, which is 2, which is equal to 6 hours. So after 6 hours, x and y would meet, and x and z meet at what time intervals? After how many time intervals do x and z meet? X and z meet after 12 divided by the relative velocity of x and z, which is 15, 12 by 15. After every 12 by 15 hours, they meet. So how many times would they meet in 6 hours? That is what the question is asking. 6 divided by 12 by 15, 15 by 2, right? And of course, we have to take only the integer portion of this because fraction does not matter. They would have met 7 times, 7 full times, and then they would have each covered some more distance. Right? But that doesn't matter. They would have met 7 times. That's the answer. Again, we are using the fact that the meeting points are symmetrical with respect to time. And that is the key here. This we were able to do this division only because the meeting points are symmetrical in time. Now, this is another question, and here we would directly apply this. These questions are becoming very, very common. So don't think that they are not asked in examinations. They are actually being asked more frequently in all kinds of examinations. So let's see this problem, how to solve it using slightly longer method, and then we'll be using a slightly shorter method to again solve this problem. Actually not slightly, but very short method. So there are two people who are running in opposite directions on a circle, and we are given two conditions. So we'll draw those two conditions separately. And the first condition is A runs in clockwise direction, so A is running this way, B is running this way, 500 meters in clockwise direction. So A has run how many meters? 500 meters, and they meet here. B has run how many meters? L minus 500. So what's the ratio of speeds of A and B? It is 500 divided by L minus 500. Good. So we can come up with this ratio first time, right? So this we are able to come up in the first case. In the second case, what are we told? We are told that now in anti-clockwise direction, right? So B has run 400 meters. B has run 400 meters, and A has probably run the entire circle and has come back here. So A has run one full round and then has come back here. So how much distance A has traveled? A has traveled L full, and the second L, he has traveled not full, one full L he has traveled, and the second L, he has not traveled full, but he has traveled how much? L minus 400. So the total distance L has, the A has moved is L plus L minus 400. So again, the ratio of speeds of A and B becomes 2L minus 400 divided by 400. And this ratio of speed has to remain the same. So you can probably write an equation like this and you can solve it. It would become a quadratic and the answer would come out to be 700. This is a very long method. It has a quadratic equation in there, so it would take you some time to solve it. But now we'll use the insight that the meeting points are symmetrical. So the second meeting point, B has traveled 400 meters. The first meeting point, since the meeting points are symmetrical, B would have traveled how many meters? 200 meters, 400 divided by 2, which is equal to 200 meters. So this L minus 500 should have been equal to what? 200 meters, and therefore L will be equal to 700. Very simple, right? Just keep that in mind. This the key here in all problems which involve meeting point, the key is to understand that meeting points are symmetrical in time and symmetrical in distance. With this, we end this class. In subsequent classes, we'll solve slightly tricky problems, again involving circular tracks, because these problems are becoming so common and they are so frequently asked with slight variations in examinations. They are becoming a favorite. I had to sort of divide them into two classes. And in the next class, we'll solve some tricky problems which involve head starts, which involve people starting at different regions of the track, and which involve ask questions which ask us the conditions when the participants reach different points in track, not at one point, but they are, let's say, diametrically opposite to each other, those kind of questions. So if you are interested, then do subscribe to our channel. If you have comments and questions, don't hesitate ask them. Thank you very much.